good shot till they put kids on shoulders.
And we are your hosts here for Star Wars Weekend, an exciting weekend number 6.
Hang on a second, y'all. It's the third weekend. I hate to interrupt. I know we have a lot to do today, but it's the third weekend.
No, it's weekend number 6.
Now, the first weekend.
What about Derek going
there? There was a second weekend. That was last weekend. You might have
heard. It's Star Wars weekend, so we go by Star Wars numbering. We start with number 4, then we go to number 5. Number 6, and this is the third weekend. Now, if you come back next weekend, that will be weekend number 1.
Phantom weekend.
Phantom weekend. Well, ladies and gentlemen, we're so excited to have you here.
We are excited. Now, I need to know right here and right now, where are my Star Wars fans? Woo! That's right, sir. You are in the right place. We are here celebrating our brand new spaceport, Star Tours. Who has flown on Star Tours? Well, you people, don't waste another second, a moment, don't let another day go by.
Oh.
Without getting out that blood, I have to tell you, I don't want to date ourselves.
I did that in high school. The only way I could go to prom.
Being funny. Now, humans, how many of you in the actual original spaceport flew back in 1989? Who rode that ride back in 1989? We got a few of you here. Welcome back.
All right, now I know the kids were too young to have ridden it back in 1989, but how many of your parents are such big Star Wars fan that you're named after the pilot, RX-24, or named after C-3PO? Any 3POs out there? Hey there, little IG-88. Nice to see you.
Listen, it doesn't matter what your name is, little Anakin. We are in for a great treat. We are moments away from Legends of the Force Star Wars Celebrity Motorcade.
And the crowd goes wild! Legends of the Force, featuring not one, not two, but five big Star Wars celebrities, including your host of Star Wars Weekends. That's right, he is our host all the way from Star Wars The Clone Wars. Any Clone Wars fans out there?
There are you all.
He is the voice of Obi-Wan Kenobi. If you've played video games, if you've watched cartoons or television, you've probably heard his voice. But you couldn't know it because he's the voice double for Johnny Depp, Michael J. Fox, of course, Ewan McGregor. He does hundreds of voices. He's on Batman Brave and the Bold. As I said, he's the voice of Obi-Wan Kenobi. His name is James Arnold Taylor, the host of Star Wars Weekend. Let's hear it!
Yeah! You might get a chance to get up close and personal with a real live action star from fabulous television shows like, oh, I don't know, Heroes, a blockbuster movie like X-Men, or we Star Wars fans know him from Episode 1, Phantom Menace, the relentless Sith Lord. I'm talking about Darth Maul. Ray Park is here! We do it for you, humans, because we love you.
Of course, Ray will be doing his own show at 4:45. It's a chance to get up close at the Premier Theater over by Avenue of Americas. He'll be doing a trip to the mall.
A visit to the mall today at 4:45 Premier Theater.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, now how many fans of Boba Fett in here?
Come on, let me hear it.
Behind Boba Fett from Empire Strikes Back is here. He, of course, also appeared in the James Bond series. He was on the Robin Hood television show. He was an old school Doctor Who. His name is Jeremy Bullock. Fan favorite, let's hear for Jeremy Bullock.
Yeah! But wait, Earth people, there's more.
There's more.
You might recognize our next Star Wars celebrity. She was on that popular television show, That's So Raven. She played the role of Muffy, but we Star Wars fans know her as she lends her voice to everyone's favorite Padawan in the galaxy, Ahsoka Tano. Ashley Eckstein is here!
That's right.
She'll be hosting Behind the Force, a special look at Star Wars The Clone Wars, a little bit later on today, coming up at 1:45. You don't want to also miss over in the merchandise tent located right by the Rock and Roller Coaster. You'll get a chance to see Ashley as she shows you a little bit about her universe, a brand new fashion line for fangirls. That's right, sci-fi girls have doubled in number. Come on, sci-fi girls, let me hear you! T-shirts. We want a little curve in our t-shirt. Ashley's given a geek chic to all of our t-shirts. Go check it out today at 5:45 in the merchandise tent. You'll see Ashley.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, that's a lot of stars, but we got one more coming your way. We've talked about Ahsoka Tano, but we need to talk about her master. Any fans of Anakin Skywalker out there? Here. Now, we have the voice of Anakin Skywalker here from Star Wars Clone Wars. He also appears, some of you may be fans of 90210. He He's on 90210. He was in Disaster Movie and Vampire Son. He's also been on Heroes. He's going to be lending his voice to the new holiday offering for Tinkerbell, the new Tinkerbell holiday movie. He's going to play
Sled.
But as I gotta say, this ladies, he's a good-looking fella. His name is Matt Lanter. Guys, you're gonna be jealous of all the ladies. You're gonna
okay,
be all...
let's just call a spade a spade. He is the hottie McCotterton. I'll tell you that right now.
Matt Lanter is here.
Hold the comlink phone, Dax. I'm getting a hyperspace comlink transmission saying the Legends of the Force Star Wars Celebrity Motorcade is well underway.
Oh my goodness. Well, they're about to step off, ladies and gentlemen. I have to admit, I haven't been this excited since I saw Princess Leia in that gold bikini in Return of the Jedi.
Come on, just goes to show you men are the same no matter what galaxy they're from. Listen, you ladies, we are so excited about this motorcade. We are going to help launch this thing off. We're going to need you humans. Are you willing to help us out? Let me hear you say yes!
Yeah.
Huh? This is a pretty big deal. You want them to help.
Oh yeah, these humans, they can do it. I believe in the power of the humans.
All right, so what do you have in mind?
I think we need to use a little force.
Okay, we're gonna force them to do it. You are gonna help us start the parade, and you're gonna like it, and I am judging you by your size.
That's not what we're doing here. Jax, I'm talking about the force. These are not the droids you're looking for. Force, not that force.
Oh,
got it confused.
The force.
Right.
Ah, I understand.
Yeah. Oh, the force.
Yes, it will be one.
It surrounds us. It binds us.
You
it's
know
like
what?
Cheese.
You're kind of like a lava lamp. Fun to look at, not too bright. Here's what we're going to do, humans. I'm going to ask you to throw your right hands in the air.
And women like you just don't care.
No.
And if you want to party like a Boba Fett,
let's hear it for the white boy, everybody. Listen, I want those humans to raise your right hand in the air and scream out on the count of three. A long time ago, in a galaxy far, far away.
Okay, if you don't know that line, you were at the wrong weekend.
Let's go.
All right,
here
so
we
get
go.
Those hands on up.
On the count of three. A long time ago in a galaxy far, far away. One,
two,
three.
A long time ago in a galaxy far, far away.
Donald Duck and Goofy.
Oh,
Not yet.
All right, we're talking about the 4, 5, or 6. How about episodes 1, 2, and 3? Let's hear from 1, 2, and 3.
Is in their young hands. Ladies and gentlemen, the Jedi Master and Padawan Learners from our very own Jedi Training Academy.
Yeah, Mickey's right there.
Ladies and gentlemen, right now we have two great things coming together.
Two great things like peanut butter and chocolate.
Like peanut butter and jelly.
Do you mean the incredible minds of Walt Disney and the creative forces of George Lucas coming up with an
Princess Leia. Let's hear from Princess Minnie Organa.
And look at those gorgeous cinnabons on her head. He's too old to be a stormtrooper, but there he is. Stormtrooper Donald!
And of course, right here, the dork lord of the Sith himself.
Well, that's cute.
That's it for Darth Goopy. Ladies and gentlemen, from our very own Jedi Training Academy, here we have some young Padawans.
Being led by Jedi Master.
Oh, that is, their Midichlorian count is off the charts.
I don't know about you, if you could see from where I'm, I see a youngling, he looks like a mini Maul. Mini Darth Maul, we still have time to change him. And of course, wherever you see amazing younglings, not too far behind, even more amazing parents. Let's hear it for the parents of the younglings!
Star Wars now. We've got Minnie Mouse as Princess Leia. We've got Darth Goofy.
He looks good.
Well, he's missing something.
He's got his helmet, his gloves, his cape.
Yeah, but look down, Goofy. Look down.
Fancy pants right over there.
Let's hear for the irascible. My favorite. Let's hear for Donald Duck. Ow!
Yeah, ladies and gentlemen, there they go. The Fab Three, Star Wars style.
Hey, let's hear for our younglings from the Jedi Training Academy.
Here to maintain law and order in our galaxy. They're 4,000 members strong and have units stationed around the planet. Please welcome the largest Imperial presence here at Disney's Hollywood Studios, the 501st Legion.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, if you want your younglings to take part in the Jedi Training Academy, you gotta get over to the Jedi Training Academy stage right over by the brand new Star Tours.
The adventure continues.
Right over there. Get there early though, spots go quickly, isn't that right, Jedi Master? Nice.
You know, Dex, it just wouldn't be a Star Wars weekend without the presence of the 501st. Here they come right now.
Actually, being glad about this, of course, the 501st Legion. This is Star Wars fandom at its finest, ladies and gentlemen. They've taken their love of Star Wars, their love of costuming, and they've come together into a group that is given back to organizations, charitable organizations around the country.
Organizations like
MS
Foundation,
the American Red Cross,
Big Brothers and Big Sisters,
Relay for Life,
Give Kids the World,
the American Heart Association,
Children's Diabetes, and many more.
And Make-A-Wish Foundation. In fact, just today, the 501st Legion was doing something special for a young man named Jordan. So we want to give a big round of applause for the 501st Legion and their sister organization, the Rebel Legion. Let's hear it for them. Special guests from around the country and in fact the world, including some guests from Australia. That's right. That likes to recognize, of course, Senator Bail Organa. All right, we've got a next wing pilot. You might recognize this guy from Yavin 4. He was the one that did this.
I remember him. Because Anakin Skywalker was there. I got a question. Why did Anakin Skywalker grow into be Darth Vader?
I don't know.
People call him Annie all the time.
That's true.
You were too big.
We also have guests, of course, from Nebraska, New Orleans, Ohio, Tennessee, Texas. So we've got, of course, some guests that are joining the Florida Garrison. We've got Commander Gree over here. We've got Commander Keeley. The Hammer is here. We've got all representatives of ARF Trooper, Advanced Recon Force Trooper in the camouflage. All the way from the Clone Wars. Let's hear it for him. Of course, here's the honor guard of the 501st Legion, ladies and gentlemen. The bad guys. Let's hear it for the dark side. Any fans of the dark side out there?
Yeah. I'm the dark side. After all, being the dark side today means you're in the shade. That's a good thing. I know it.
How about the good guys? Any fans of the good guys? Yeah. Some Imperial officers. Imperial Guard. Ah, Count Dooku is here.
And
of course, we have some stealth troopers, better known as the shadow troopers here in all black. A covert force. ATST pilot. Right here from the Death Star. They were part of the fight for the Death Star cannon.
Yep.
Not used to that.
TIE fighter pilots?
Ah, yes, some TIE pilots coming. Very good. Of course, you all know that TIE stands for Twin Ion Engine, right? Right?
Of course you do.
But you're Star Wars fans.
We're the only one. Thanks for the information.
What do you say, young ladies? Can you raise those sabers up nice and high? Come on, let's hear one. Ah, there you go. And of course, from the Battle of Hoth, you might recognize these next guys.
Some call them snowtroopers, others call them blizzard force, because they can destroy a planet fast and hard, like a blizzard.
Blizzard force is also my favorite snack at DQ.
What?
It's true, exactly. An AT-AT pilot going on there. And of course,
stormtroopers.
Ubiquitous stormtroopers.
The most loyal to the Emperor.
That's right. You've seen these guys in episodes 4, 5, and 6. People often ask, you know, the clone troopers in the Clone Wars are awesome. You know, they're awesome troops. And by the time you get to 4, 5, and 6, let's admit it, these guys can't hit the side of the barn. It's true. You know, they can't hit it. There's only three guys trying to escape from the Death Star. Come on, guys. And one Wookiee, and he's big. But that's because they're copies of copies of copies. They start getting a little fuzzy around the edges. Oh, using the younglings are using the force against them. Very good.
The force is strong with them. Hey, wait a second. Turn around. These two right here, I think I see. Are these the twins from Harry Potter? Oh, no. Okay.
We have some fighter scouts, some scout troopers. Hey, guys, watch out for that tree.
Oh, that armor's not equipped to hold that together.
And of course, these guys might be looking for some droids on Tatooine, but guys,
these aren't the droids you're looking for.
Ladies and gentlemen, how about another big round of applause for the 501st Legion! Over 6,000 strong in the world. Garrisons all around the world. We're lucky to have them here. We're always an honor to have the 501st Legion join us here. By the way, you can get that armor buffed out for $99.95. Well tried.
That's the way to be, younglings. Well done. Chase away the Tusken Raiders. They're chafy people. Sand in places you just don't want to know.
Oh, no, that's true.
They're happiest at the Olive Garden.
Why is that?
Eating their Tusken chicken.
They do. They love it. Oh, Greedo is here. Hey, Greedo, Han Solo wanted to invite you out for a shot.
Uh-oh.
Watch your mouth.
Sweet and adorable little Ewoks. Come on, humans, let me hear you say, aww. Adorable little Ewoks. Say, little Ewok, I got a question for you. What happens if Luke Skywalker's star speeder breaks down in Endor?
I don't know.
Ewoks.
Oh, that's well, ladies and gentlemen, that is our honor guard for the Legends of the Force, Starvish, Lever, Mordecai. That's the 501st Legion, Florida Garrison. They did a great job. How many of you had a chance to ride the new Star Tours? How many of you had a chance? How many of you had a chance to ride it more than once? So, as I understand it, there's 50 different adventures. Who's been to Hoth? Who's been to Hoth?
I wish we were at Hoth right now.
It's true. I think I'm overdressed for this weather. This is genuine dewback.
So humans, we've got a lot of things coming up a little bit later on today at 2:10, the first of two Padawan Mind Challenges.
That's right, the younglings will want to participate in that. It's a trivia contest, all featuring questions from Star Wars The Clone Wars.
Don't forget to visit
our first guest is the action star featured in such blockbusters as Sleepy Hollow and X-Men and the hit TV show Heroes. He also played the ninja master Snake Eyes in G.I. Joe, The Rise of Cobra. But Star Wars fans know him as the relentless Sith Lord, Darth Maul. Please welcome Ray Park. Has a career that has spanned over four decades. But he is most known for bringing to life one of the most popular villains in the Star Wars saga. He is the man behind the notorious bounty hunter Boba Fett. From The Empire Strikes Back and Return of the Jedi, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Jeremy Bullock.
Coming on to the stage right now, everybody's favorite Wookiee. Let's hear it for Chewie.
Third celebrity guest has appeared in many popular film and television projects, including Eight Simple Rules, Point Pleasant, Commander in Chief, Heroes, Disaster Movie, and 90210. Star Wars fans know him best as the voice of Jedi Knight Anakin Skywalker from Star Wars The Clone Wars. Please welcome Matt Lanter.
Jedi Masters, Shock Team, Kid Fisto, and Mace Windu. What does Mace Windu?
I don't know.
Anything Mace Woman say? That's right, Mace. Are you hearing me?
Our next guest played Muffy on the hit Disney Channel series, That's So Raven. She also provides the voice for Anakin Skywalker's Padawan learner, Ahsoka Tano, in Star Wars The Clone Wars, and is the creator of her universe, an apparel line especially designed for fangirls. She once again reprises her role as host for Behind the Force. Please welcome Ashley Eckstein.
You know, for a Dark Lord of the Sith, look at Rey out here being nice.
He sure is friendly.
He sure is a nice guy. Let's hear from Rey Park. Darth Maul from Revenge of the Sith joining us on stage right now with his counterpart, Darth Maul.
I've got about a minute left of battery anyway.
We can kill you to smile, Darth Maul. That's it, don't smile.
He can't stay here, Mom. He's got a school.
Oh. And of course, here's Jeremy Bullock, Boba Fett, ladies and gentlemen.
Come on, Boba.
Acting legend. Among his numerous credits, he is the voice of Johnny Test, Leonardo in the hit computer animated film Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, and the world's most famous caveman, Fred Flintstone. Star Wars fans will recognize his voice as Jedi Master Obi-Wan Kenobi from the hit computer animated TV series Star Wars The Clone Wars. Please welcome your Star Wars Weekends host, James Arnold Taylor.
I think Matt Lanter just joined us on stage. Let's hear it for the voice of Anakin Skywalker, Matt Lanter.
She's everybody's favorite out of one of the galaxy. Here comes Ahsoka Tano. Clone Wars. Of course, she lent her voice to Ahsoka Tano, created her own, her universe of fangirl fashion line. Please put your hands together, Ashley Eckstein!
Ladies and here's some of the bad guys. We've got, of course, Count Dooku's assassin, Massage Ventress, joining us.
Massage, if you were 12 inches tall, you'd be a foot Massage.
And some of the most feared bounty hunters in the galaxy. From Attack of the Clones, we have Zam Wessel. From Phantom Menace and the Clone Wars, we have Ara Singh. And of course, the father of all the clones out there. Let's hear it for Jango Fence. Jeremy, I think you recognize this next guy over here. No, you don't? Well, let me introduce you. This, Jeremy, this is Boba Fett. Let's hear it for Boba Fett, ladies and gentlemen.